good? What's good? That shit TV. We in the motherfucking building. You know what I'm saying? Hottest podcast in the city.
Yes, sir.
You already know what it is. You already know what it is. I fuck with you, what you said. That shit last time. I said, in the city. You know what I'm saying? We got my man TREYVON HESTER in the motherfucking building.
Yes,
we
sir.
Locked in, you know what I'm saying? And we about to get this shit popping, so we about to turn this bitch up. You know what I'm saying? Play this hot-ass track real quick. Get y'all lit, because you know we about to turn it up. You know what I'm saying? And get this vibe rolling, so let's go.
Damn. Mm.
New channel, chill, but I'm hot as Tucson. Protecting the brand, I went bought some more guns. Roll up some shit, look like elephant thumbs. Bag is your time, set the watch on my arm. Bitches gon' milk, cause I'm lit like a candle. I'm never lacking, getting hit with my hammer. I ain't used to none, she thought Chanel was channel. When I record, she show out for the camera. Buzz down the Cartier, yeah, playing Jane and Hublot. One bitch that's Uno with me and this Tudo. Thoughts in a Lambo, I done went Pluto. Me and this money, a dynamic duo. Slam on the op, hit his ass with the suplex. Live in a condo and trap out the duplex. Ice on my collar, can't tell this a crew neck. Walk on the spot, all the hoes hollin' who they on. I did a feature, they pay with biscotti. Used to be OG, but now it's exotic. No dykes around, but my scrap in the party. They pray for my ending, but I just got started. Gate in my house, you can't find it on Zillow. Can't go to sleep, broke up a million, my pillow. Knock off a op, then I fuck on his widow. He catch me a flight, turn a little Johnny yellow. I go ham, but no pork on my floor. Took a jet from LA to New York. Know I'm lit, but I'm just heating up. It's way too early to be passing the torch.
Can't do that.
I turned the condo to a trap spot. Let a nigga take my chain, I bet not. Already too late if you see that red dot. Bow.
Protecting the brand, I just bought some new Glock. Coronavirus, they went out of stock. I get my shooters high price for your top. Guarantee one day your body gon' drop. Guarantee one day them bitches gon' hate on me. Guarantee this a day they gon' get caught. I put that AK right there in your face. You know when it's a robbery, you can't move a lot. Walk in the spot, all the rappers, they get back. I'm the same niggas they cop for they shit back. I make my bitches break down like a Kit Kat. You want that smoke, but you know you not with that. I might work out on your bitch like a six pack. Fill in my head, it camp chain with the baguettes. I'm not the typical nigga, you fussy. You not the typical bitch I would hush for. Gotta let you know you playin' with a dun. I put that car to your watch on my arm. I done did so much dirt under the sun. I done did so much good shit for my mom. Rich nigga flow, come from the slums. I shoot my ass on no spot, I don't run. I got a bitch out in Cat and she blunt. I spent my money with shine, so I won.
Tennis on choppers, the meat is a throwback. Spot in Miami, I'm free in Lakota. Bull on the lay, I'm there matching my Zodiac. I'm having Zoom calls back of the Maybach. If it ain't about millions, let me be his shoe. Don't trip me, nigga, thinking it's cool. No fuck should be tolerated in the crew. And we don't make world star, we make the news. And everything mafia, mafia, and everything profitable. I don't see nothing from stopping them. My bitch want a Birkin, I'm copping them. Copping the dog want a body, he dropping them. Baguette the chain, make it look different. Pull down the Richard, the rock in the kitchen. Okay. Get him a stack to clean up the dishes. Don't talk on the phone, we know that they listen. The trapping, producing 100 a day. Bag been charging 100 a day. Young thing gon' keep 100 in the K. Another 100 on the way, fish scale. Every nigga with me get a plate for real. Every nigga with me sell weight still. Every nigga with me go 8 for real. I'ma teach you how to work that Drake for real. Like how you make that ass shake for real. I'ma fuck you in front of that Ray for real. Your boyfriend the but you safe for real.
Got a new chain and that bitch come from Wavin. He got a rollie, he just beat the body. You know it ain't my shit if it ain't exotic. She wanna kick it, I don't do karate. I'm like, look, shawty, I'm feeling your body. Bought her a Cuban, the penis, they got it.
Y'all know what the fuck it is, man. Vibeship TV and this motherfucker.
It's a motherfucking,
you know,
vibe.
It's a motherfucking vibe, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know I mean, some.
Monster, man.
Let's turn that bitch up.
Let's go.
I just need my space right now.
Shit be if you was still here. Pain running deep, I can't even show it. Don't tell them about your feelings, don't nobody care. Fucking up the check, man, I'm doing shit for fun. Getting real money, man, I love it here. I press a button, nigga, I'll turn it up. Buying crystal like it's Bel Air. Buying codeine like this shit deep. Big boy blunts like my nigga Eve. Punching in the rubber, watch me bobbing weed. My hoe looking good, we ain't buying weed. Keep it 2 trill, last ever dying breed. I just woke up cold sweat, I got demons over me. Nigga, whole week, creeping on the low. Probably wouldn't never say a word if I was broke. Matter of fact, you wouldn't see me, I be gone. Shorty praying like she E.T. took her home. Windows tinted on the freeway, getting dumb. I been loading up on the straps, she's crazy. Boy, you better get up off your ass, pre-80s. Pooty touch my lamp like face, be patient. But mama told me never leave nothing on the table. Yeah, she can't even dance with the money off the She can't even dance with the money off the stage. Man, I can't complain, man, all this shit is profit. My nigga in the feds and he eatin' steak and lobster.
Absolutely. Let's get this motherfucker popping.
That's good.
All right. Yeah, but we about to get into it. You know what I'm saying? Vibeship TV. We about to rock this motherfucker. So you look, man, we got my man TREYVON HESTER, man. We about to go to fucking what y'all know. You know what I'm saying? We here to talk about his NFL career. We about to really get into this NFL career. You know what I'm saying? Talking about how he got into the NFL. And how he actually, you know what I'm saying, conquered some of the things in his life, you know what I'm saying, and got to that next level. And the whole thing about it is, man, we want y'all to really know, like, it ain't easy. And he persevered a lot of things, you know what I'm saying? I know this, you know what I'm saying? I know him personally, you know what I'm saying? He overcame a lot of things coming from where we come from, you know what I'm saying, and going through the things we go through in life. But he overseen all those obstacles and made it, so we're going to get into it, you know what I'm saying? TREYVON, you know what I'm saying, Hester. You know what I'm saying? Let's get it.
Hey, bro. Definitely starting off, like, I want you to give everybody a background from the beginning, if you could.
Yeah, no question. So, I mean, basically born and raised Pittsburgh, PA, but Wilkinsburg, to be exact.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And to be honest, you know, I'm putting it all on wax. Cause a lot of people be like, yo, what part of the hood you from? And that's like, look, I represent the whole hood.
Mm-hmm. Like, gotcha.
Like I can travel through wherever. Like we stayed in the town, went to school.
Facts.
Kelly, right. People's from the U.
Mm-hmm. Facts.
So it's like it's love everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Facts.
You know what I mean?
Right.
So when I say I represent the hood, I represent the whole hood.
Yes,
you know what I mean? Uh-huh. That's what we shouting out. I ain't just going.
Yeah,
put one section up, but you feel me? Because at the end of the day, it's all love.
We all together when it comes to it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And that's what I try to move with. But started out Little League in Wilkinsburg, you know what I'm saying, playing with a lot of good dudes that was athletes.
Yeah, could you name a few? Name two or three if you could.
Man, my brother Sean Brisker.
Okay.
Leak Garland.
Uh-huh, Leak. Swear.
Shit. Don Willis.
Nice.
So many people,
still playing
bro.
Football,
yeah.
Too.
Yeah, swear. So I mean, that was from the hood. I don't even want to leave nobody out. But
I dig it. I dig it.
Yeah. Started like that. And I mean, as a youngin', like, you know, y'all know my big bro. So, I mean, you know.
Yeah. Tone shout the tone bone.
Come from a big family. So, you know, it's love. It's like I said, it's love everywhere. And I mean, like how I came up, you know, we came up rough, but
right.
You know what I'm saying? You know, we was taught a lot of good principles, you know what I'm saying?
How to, values.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know, how to be upstanding gentlemen out here and you know, to take care of our own. And
that's good.
You know,
that's
at the end of the day, that's what it takes for real.
Right, right.
How did you parlay that in to going pro when you first got into the league? How did you incorporate those values that you learned from, you know what I'm saying, growing up?
That's crazy because, to be honest, just being myself, period, is what I do. Like, you know, like whatever, you know, I learned coming into this, like whatever I got taught, you know, from being in the hood, you know what I'm saying, from coming from the struggle, you know, I just hold that near and there and just, you know, try to keep that
true.
Yeah, for sure. All always, right. No matter where I'm at, no matter what type of soil I'm on, you know, I'm
humble
always,
yourself every way you can.
So, sure. When you first got into like football, I'm talking about like the very beginning, like pops when he got you into it. Mm-hmm. Did you like it at first?
It's crazy. I was the only one that liked it out of all my bros.
So you, but what did you like about it when you first got into the hitting?
I'm gonna be 100. So like. I wanted to be like my pops all the way around the board. Yeah. Like, okay. You know what I'm saying? So just the type man he was, the type dude he was, that's just what I looked up to. He was my first like ever role model, superhero, yeah. whatever you want to call it. You feel me? So like that's just what I wanted to do. So he loved football so much that, you feel me, me wanting to be like that, that's what I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. You feel me? So when I seen Big Bro playing, I was like, look, yeah. I'm next up. Sign me right up. You know what I'm saying? And it's crazy because I got a little brother right under me, Reek, and he was like way better than me. Like, man,
he said he way better than
me. He was way better than me, bro. Yeah. I'm talking about, man, take 100-yarder runs to the crib, all that. Like, talking about a different breed.
But that's crazy because, like, even you saying that, like, with Iceman, because Iceman played football and he was really nice.
Yeah.
He's fast as fuck. Like, bro, I remember we used to be trying to race. I'm like, this thing's fast. Like, you know what I'm saying? But his brother was a different type of beast. Like, yeah, I mean, he was like, oh, he's a different type of beast. It's like, why is it? It's like that. It's like, the older brother played football, but the young bro, it's like Mike Vick's brother. They say he was a monster. You know what I'm saying? But he was just savagey.
Man, shout out Booby, too, man. Shout out Booby Miles, man.
Savage, bro.
Booby, little Booby doing his thing, man.
So you actually know him, too. You said met him.
For sure, you already know.
You know what I'm saying? So he
was good. It's your boy Dreyking, man. It's Vibeship TV, and this episode is sponsored by Royal Faith Designer. Got my man Lay Like the Chips with me right here, man. We about to get you guys tuned in to this Royal Faith Designer. Now, if you want to go get some Royal Faith Designer, man, I want you to get that right now, man. This Royal Faith Designer is like one of the best brands out there. It's an upcoming brand out there in Pittsburgh, and this brand right here, man, it's gonna make you feel real royal. Mm-hmm. You're going to have a little bit of faith, and you're going to be able to design yourself, right?
Yes, sir.
So we want you to design yourself with the sweatsuit, you know what I'm saying? So we got them on deck. You can go ahead and go get them red ones, the yellow one. You can get a green one. You can get a black one.
All of them.
You can get, you know what I'm saying, a motherfucking blue one. You can get, you know what I'm saying, even the pink ones, you know what I'm saying? So for the ladies, I want y'all to tap in right now and get you that Royal Faith Designer. We even got the bags, the fanny packs that you like to wear in the summer.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? You can rock those too. And when you get the fanny packs, what come with it, right, is a pair of Royal Faith Designer socks. So we got a few things going on, you know what I'm saying? You got some deals. So if you want to get some of those deals right now, I want you to go to that website, https, you know what I'm saying, you know, / royalfaithdesigner.com, and go tune in and go get you some Royal Faith Designer. Get it. That's what y'all call it. Yeah. I just call it Bo Miles.
All right, see, I just had it down a different name.
I'm talking about the little Brody, you know,
For sure. That's so crazy because it's like, y'all was playing on the same team, right?
No, we ain't never playing on the same team, but, well, yeah, in Philly. In Philly, when he had first got drafted, I was there.
You still there?
Yeah, for his first couple, like the preseason and all that, and then I had got released, but I was with bro as soon as he had got in there, got his foot wet, you know what I'm saying? It was all love, man. I swear. And now he taking it and running with it.
So, all right, so when you young, how many years you was playing football? So basically, you've been playing football all your life?
My whole life.
Your whole life.
Whole life.
And did you know, you know what I'm saying, when you were young, you was like, I know I'm going to make it to the NFL, or you was like, you knew it as time went on, and that you was like, oh, I could do this, and I could definitely make it, or you was like, I'm going to make it from the jump. You want to make it to the NFL.
Like, if I was, like, if anybody was to ever meet any of my teachers or whatever from back in the day, grade saying, school,
they tell you.
It was instilled into your mind.
I'm playing in the league. Look, I read it on any report.
Absolutely.
I don't know what team, whatever.
That's
powerful.
I'm going to the league.
He wrote it on. He said, I wrote it down.
Everything.
You manifested it down.
Manifested that shit.
And through the good, through the bad. Like, whenever I was going through whatever I was going through, middle school, not going to school or whatever, it was like I still knew what the dream was. And what the focus was, it was like, look, I'm gonna get on whenever I get on that field, I'm gonna make something shake.
And that's what it was about. I ain't gonna stunt, bro. And all your highlights since high school and up, like, I always peeping, like, I was like, damn, like, bro, really be getting filthy out there. Toledo, bro, you was getting filthy. Raiders, you was getting filthy. Eagles, you was getting filthy. Bro, everywhere you just you yourself, bro, like you said, it's definitely installed in you, bro. Like, I was like,
bro don't play around. When he get through that line, he don't care who's there, who's around, who's to the left, who's to the right. He know who the target is. You know what I'm saying?
No, bro.
I was like, sheesh.
That right there, that just come from that little league. Everything that I know now come from little league. I got my toughness. I got, you know what I'm saying, my resiliency, my dedication. I got all that from the hood.
Right.
The hood really teaches you so much. And they know, they despise it, you know what I'm saying, because of the murders and a lot of stuff that go on. But, man, like, coming
keep
up,
you on your toes, though. Look, man, a lot of stuff kept you on your toes.
What was the goal? To make it out of the hood. Feel me? Like, even if you was hustling, whatever you was doing, you was trying to do this to get out.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And so when you do get out, like, you get out, you try to pull out whoever you can.
Life,
by
bro.
Motivating them, by doing whatever you can do. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people say get out and give them the bread or come back with the money, but it'd be like,
it's a little bit more than the money, bro.
I'm not going to stunt.
You got to teach them how to fish.
You can't let them give them the fish.
You can't do that.
You got to teach them, bro.
Yeah, because if you keep giving them the fish, you're going to be keep giving them.
Yeah, they're going to
every day, every time. They're going to be like, yo, bro, could you like, man, I keep. Mm. You know what I'm saying? And I get that. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's definitely that. And like we was just talking about, you know what I'm saying, before these cameras cut on, bro. It's like we know that every person, they mind gotta change, bro.
Mm-hmm.
And I realize that with life, like our minds gotta change.
Mm-hmm.
I'm starting to find out things about myself, you know what I'm saying, just by, you know, sitting down in a quiet place to understand who I am.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's what a lot of people ain't got. I think, you know, when you're raising the hood, there's so much going on. You ain't got time to sit down and do that. That's what we start saying. I ain't got time for that.
Yeah.
I ain't got time to read a book. I ain't got time to sit down and learn something. I ain't got time to do this and that.
Mm-hmm.
But what you're really saying is that you're denying yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You deny. Yeah. You deny who you, what you need to really tap into. Because that's the key. It's you.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? There's nobody else going to bring you a million. Mm-hmm. There's nobody, none of your homies. I don't care how many homies you got. That might be your brother. You might love him to death. But at the end of the day, they're not about to pave the way for you.
Mm-hmm.
So everybody got to work in some type of capacity to get where they need to be.
No question.
So it's like, yeah, I mean, that's definitely what it is. You know what I'm saying? You know, you said, Shay, you be saying, like you just said, you was like, man, I try to help them any way possible. Because, I mean, you trying to shine your light on them. Like, bro, you can go get the light, too. Go get where you need to be in. And I've seen some different things.
Yeah.
And you've been around to cities. Because, you know, in the NFL, y'all moving around a lot. So you've seen the opportunities that people's missing. So when you come back to your city, it's like, bro, y'all don't know what's going on, bro.
Yo.
Y'all missing what's really happening out here. Like, because we moving in slow times where we from. Like, you know what I'm saying? I always say that, like, Pittsburgh's a slow city, bro.
Yeah.
It's not really for us and the minorities. That, you know what I'm saying? It's not really for us. It's really, yeah, I mean, you got to go to places where there's a lot of us to be able to connect with those other people, because people's got opportunities out here for you in other places.
Yeah, and
big time, they willing to give it to you.
It's real, though, to be honest. Like, a lot of people in the city is great networkers.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you put them on a different place.
Like, bro, and they'll kill.
Come on, bro.
They blow up anybody, bro.
Anywhere, too. So it's like, you know what I'm saying? Why not get out and try to do that? Why not try to spread your wings?
Right.
Leave and just see where
it can take you. Yeah.
Really open your mind up. Because that should take you forward.
Afraid of failure.
Yeah.
That's what it'd be, too. They'd definitely be scared of failing, bro.
The fact that you went to the NFL, bro, and you made it, you wasn't afraid of failure.
Nope.
It was obsolete to you. It was like, no, I don't even care about that. Like, bro, I just know I'm going to get there. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because it's like, people, that's the thing. And like we said, failure's the best teacher.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? They told you, like you said, even Lay said, it's like, bro, in school, when you said they failed, it was like, it was a bad thing. Oh, you failed. You got F's, you're going bad. It's like, bro, like, but he can learn from the mistakes. Like, Nobody's not telling him that.
And they don't want to say that shit.
Like, it's not okay. Like, you're not supposed to make no mistake. I'm trying to get a straight A. But they're not telling you that, bro, it's okay if you didn't get the straight A or you didn't get the B's or the C's. Matter of fact, some of that stuff don't even really matter. It's just trying to see where your potential's at.
But they say you also, too, you got to learn from your mistakes.
To be successful,
you know what I mean? So, you know, when you do that, you ain't got no choice but to elevate and grow.
Speaking of mistakes, the techniques you had to learn in the NFL, how was that process?
So I had actually switched positions when I got to high school. So I was always more considered like a running back or like a fullback coming in, and then when I got to high school, I grew And ended up putting my hand in the dirt.
Bro, I remember when Rosie and you wrote to the right, said, "You're big as fuck. Still beat you the fuck up. Come here, give me a hug, nigga." Bro, heavy in tears, bro.
Eric caught everybody off guard.
Facts, bro. I was like, damn, bro.
So when you went to Toledo, when you was there, now did you more so go for like the education, or were their program up there, was it kind of like to get you ready to, you know, get drafted?
To be honest, bro, I had the gray shirt my first year. My first year at Toledo, okay. I had to pay for my first two semesters of college.
Okay.
Mm. Like, it's crazy for real, because, like, when I had first got in the college and enrolled in the college, so my birthday's in September, I enrolled, like, August. Mm-hmm. By September, man, they was telling me I had to get up out of the dorms. I had enough money to pay because I wasn't on scholarship.
That shit really, that. They told a nigga he had to go.
Like, look, if you don't got these 5-6 rocks, bro, like,
you gotta go.
And that's when Pops was already locked up each week. Yeah. Like, look, it was hard times.
Right.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, like, there's a part of in a future song, he said, "I done came from sleeping on floors, you can't persuade me."
Yeah.
Ooh,
like,
yeah.
I really came from sleeping on floors. Like, mm-hmm. I told my dog that was up there in college, like, "Look, bro, like, I ain't got nowhere. Like,
yeah,
I gotta, like, put this little cot on the ground. Like, let's get it.
Let's get, yeah.
Next five, six months, like, look, we making it work. Going to class, you know what I mean? Whatever we gotta do, we gotta do it."
I love the fact that you said that, because, bro, I ain't trying to sway off your topic, but I remember when I first got my first crib, there was nothing in that motherfucker.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And all I had was my big, that from my mom's crib, I had my clothes. Fire. I had the furniture, you know what I'm saying? My aunt gave me a TV, little small ass dip. Mm. I had to go buy a little stand to put it on. Like, and it was like, I was laying there on the floor the first night, but I was the most happiest nigga alive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can definitely relate to that. Because that was on my first one.
Bro, like, you know, I got my shit, dog. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, but I know the struggle. Like, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, I didn't care about my stuff looking low. I didn't, all I care was like, bro, I just need to get to point A, point B. And it's like, and I look at other people in other countries, bro, that go through worse conditions than us. And it's like, when a person's in a situation, you was in a situation, I felt like you was like, "Hey, I'm gonna do what I gotta do, though."
Yeah,
mm-hmm. I'm saying it ain't about nothing. Like,
gotta,
I'm saying,
you gotta have a vision, you gotta understand what the purpose is out here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I mean, I could have easily came back to the hood and
said, "Fuck it,
absolutely."
That could have been a green light. Like, look, man, look, come back to the hood. Mm-hmm. And it was crazy because by the end of my freshman semester, my pops had passed away, so it was really, look, bro, what you doing this for? I wasn't even on the field yet. Like, man, come on, we could wrap this up right now.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But it was like, nah, we said what we was going to do, and we going to do it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
That's crazy. That type of focus is so rare, bro. Yeah. Like, especially with athletes. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of motherfuckers like us, they would have did just what you said you didn't do and what you didn't do. They just slid right back into the, this ain't working.
Exactly, bro.
And I got to go do this. You know what I'm saying? And their talent is wasted. You know what I'm saying? So.
And it's crazy because I really, like, I honestly know people that's from the same hood as us.
Mm-hmm.
That's better than athletes that I've been around in the league.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I'm not, that's crazy. That's not far-fetched.
Yeah.
You're right, though. Because even when we used to get together, like, even turkey bowls, like, from youngins and up,
mm-hmm.
I remember I was like, bro, 12, 13. I'm like, why do y'all got me on the line with this grown ass man? I'm about to dig in my ass. I held my own. I ain't gonna start, but I forget Bull from the Hood, bro.
Like.
I forget Bull from the Hood. I think his name was Ray Ray, bro. But he was fast as fuck. I can't remember, like, his real name. But he used to go to Holy Rosary too, but he was fast as fuck, bro. Like, Eugene Jarvis fast. You know what I mean? I was 12. I'm like, this nigga's getting filthy, old nigga.
You know, there's 30 niggas named Ray Ray from the hood.
I'm one of them, bro. And free little Ray Ray. You know what I'm saying?
Shot.
For real, man. Free all of them, man.
For real. Free all of them. Yeah. Because there's some talented motherfuckers in jail. Jesus. Like, bro, that'd be a shame. I'd just be feeling like, he was like mad scientist, like, nigga talented, but he wild as hell.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a mixture. Yeah. Like, mm-hmm. like, he talented, like, they niggas is in the jail making guns, bro.
Yeah,
but how is you making straps in here, bro? Oh yeah, you got all the time in the world to be doing that.
Tattoo
with nails,
hell yeah.
Guns be official, bro. Be like, yo, I don't even got tats, but I want one. I see that gun, bro.
Swear, my bro came in with tats like, yeah, you know you get a Madeira. I'm like, you got a Madeira.
Okay. And they be official, bro. Yeah. Like, they
official. Like, they tell you, though, like, the old way of tatting is the best way. Because they carve it in your skin instead of the needle poking at it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you look at the Chinese tat, you know how they should be detailed. Nigga be with the stick, like. That's hours of work. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, with the gun, it's like, it cut the time down. So back in ancient times, that's how they tatted up everybody.
Wow.
They would dip the ink and then they get the carving. You know what I'm saying? And that should be more detailed because it's permanent, like, and it's stronger into your skin. Mm. That's all they're doing is putting the ink underneath the wound. Mm. And then they make the tattoo come out like the way it is.
My tattoos hurt.
Yeah. My girl just got all of my kid, all of her kids on her shoulder.
They got like 8.
Swear.
They got like 8. They had a couple.
But back to what we were saying, though, like, I ain't going to get too sweaty on the top. But as far as like the NFL career, I heard about the sack on Tom Brady. The sack on Tom
How did that
Brady?
Feel?
How did that feel? You probably were like, nigga, I got that nigga. I got him, fam. He's just over. I got him. I know you was hyped, bro. You sound like going crazy.
He's like, hold on now, bro. We talking,
Brady, bro.
He still got 4 quarters to play this motherfucker.
Yeah, like, hold on. You got to hold your energy right now. You know what I'm saying? We
need you to get his ass again.
You got to give him at least 5 more times before you get hyped.
I'm going to be 100 because we was in Mexico when we played Tom Brady and them. So we was at the stadium. The elevation was like being in Denver, so it was hard to breathe.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that shit.
They had that fast pace. He on the line.
Slinging.
We got beat on him. Look, that play did not matter, man. I'm throwing 40, 40, 50 on it, man. We on the flight back. Look, bro.
I need you to get his ass.
Bro, I don't want to hear nothing about that play.
That's some shit Ray Lewis said, bro. This is some real shit. And then I'm like, yo, I've been watching and like NFL for a long time, and it made perfect. And he said the thing that's wrong with the young generation of y'all NFL players that's coming up, I don't know how you feel about it, but he said no one's studying nothing.
Mm.
He said when I wanted to become the best linebacker, I one time talked to a quarterback. The quarterback said, I study defense. Mm-hmm. He said, I need to study offense.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I need to know what's going on the field.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why Tom Brady's a scientist, bro, he knows just like all the other greats what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Ray Lewis was on every play getting a sack, bro, on like every play, bro. Mm-hmm. That's because he know how to read. Mm-hmm. He said, you got young guys coming in. They not reading nothing.
Yeah.
They just playing with fire and energy. Absolutely. But they don't understand, like, bro, it's a science.
There's more.
Niggas is like, yo, drop him off the back line, put him back here. And then when it says Tom Brady's probably picking y'all apart.
Ooh, for real.
There's more to it than just being a talented player and using your talent to do what you do.
You need to know that
you gotta hone your craft. Yeah. Skill. Absolutely.
Skill and to read it.
No and even question. Going to that,
yeah.
bro.
Yeah.
Going to that, bro. The block, bro.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like,
not going to stand.
Hold on, real quick, go back. So let everybody know who was you playing with, just in case y'all don't know who the team he was on when he got the sack on Brady. So who was you?
I was with Oakland.
Okay,
so that was my rookie season.
Shout out to my pops. He's a Raiders fan. Man, shout out to my pops.
2017, man. Seventh round too. So it wasn't even nothing crazy. It was like I still was living off of hope and a dream, but you know, coming from the hood, that was like, man, made it. Didn't matter, bro.
As long as you was in the door.
On the field, when you seen the crowd, how did that feel?
Man, that was crazy, bro. It was crazy because you know I got to play in a black hole. So
you get emotional about that shit.
Oh man, you already
know. Yeah, like I'm saying, like oh man, I fucking made it.
I'm here.
Let me
pick up.
I got it, dog.
Yeah,
I can't believe it.
You took a
bite of grass, daddy. You see me right now, nigga. You look around, like, pops. You see me right now, nigga. I'm out here.
Gotta send a couple.
You know what I'm saying? I know, bro. Was like, I know your bro was like, oh my bro, really fucking made it. This shit crazy.
No lie. as soon as I got drafted, we went out to Morovo Mall and bought anything Raider gear. Like 10, 15 dudes out there, like, is that a hat? Man, let me get that.
Heavy for the hood. Yeah.
You already know.
Black out.
It's easy for the hood. We already all black. It's the, like the hood's like,
absolutely.
That's funny. You ask anybody, any regular nigga, they be like, who's your team? Raiders won't even come up, but you ask a nigga from the hood. Real niggas be like, yeah, I fuck with the Raiders, bro. I ain't even gonna hold you, bro. I be like, what? Because I was like that too. Like, I've always been, since 95, I've been a Steeler fan. Mm-hmm. And like, but I, you know, I ain't gonna lie. There's something about the Raiders. You just, the vibe is, you gotta fuck with them. You know what I'm saying? Even if you ain't from the city, you can fuck with the Raiders.
That's how I was with my pops though, bro. He's from Cali. You feel me? So he was always a Raiders fan. But I told him, I'm like, yeah, he got drafted. He said, get the fuck out of here. I said, yeah. He was like, oh, that's crazy.
How was it? Who's coaching when you was on the Eagles?
Oh man, what was his name?
It wasn't Reed, was it? No, because Reed's my man. I like when he was nice.
He was nice.
Everybody talked about Reed. Reed's a nice. He's a coach.
Dab days.
Yeah, but I fuck with the Raiders when they had Sack.
Fuck with
them.
That, bro.
Sack was in there hammering niggas, boys, bro.
I didn't got the meat side, man.
Oh yeah,
he's a big fisherman.
Yeah, yeah. Nah,
he like to be swimming in the ocean type.
Get it in, man.
Yeah. Who's like the biggest person you met that you was like, damn, bro, he's huge.
Bro, Haloti Nada.
That sound like a big ass name.
It do sound like a big ass name, don't it?
He was the D tackle that played for the Ravens.
Big
92, bro. He was the first round pick and everything.
You seen it? You like, oh.
I played with him, so he was in Philly. It was his last year before he retired. He probably gonna be a Hall of Famer. Yeah, a legend, bro. Yeah. But a real good dude. But bro, when I tell you, this man is a brick wall. Like, yo, I'm like you might stub your finger if you bump into that. Bro, there's no way for you to be like this, bro.
And we like, what you be eating, man?
He probably on the field killing.
Where did you come from?
So you ate a head for horse today on the lab like this motherfucker? Like,
were you born? Or born?
That's so
did
bro,
you come out of the movie? Swear. Did there be fear on the field for certain players?
Nah.
I don't be no fear.
Nah, like when you get that for it, bro.
He's playing. Because I know there be heavy, real injuries.
Oh, yeah.
So that's what I'm saying. Like, do niggas be nervous? Like, man, I ain't trying. Try and avoid that shit. Do niggas be nervous trying to avoid.
Depending on what they got online. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It's a business when you get there.
Right.
You know, I mean, yeah, it's fun and all that, but by the time you get there, it's a business. How much you get signed on first time? Oh, man.
You got to talk about it if you don't want to.
Yeah, I ain't going to discuss it.
My nigga.
It was something crazy, but I went seventh round, so. No, I'm gonna be 100. It wasn't even nothing that real, like 50, bro.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And you know, I went to Cali, so they took taxes out of that.
Yeah. Nigga, that's what the shit they don't tell y'all in the NFL. They don't tell you that these niggas
got the money, man.
They still got to file
30 and you know what I'm saying, on the check. And that was the first time I ever seen 30 in life. So I'm like,
oh, yeah. Nigga just got paid. You look at that account like, oh, my nigga.
That's so fucking relatable because I can relate because I do that on a regular ass check. Like, oh, let me make sure this shit's still in. Nigga then did like a whole week of OT. Nigga, we done got a stock on the check. Hold on, let me see.
Yes, sir. Because I ain't going to lie, nigga. My check be like, you know what I'm saying? Just working in the NFL, like you said, bro. I'll see like 15. I'm like, yeah, that shit there. You know what I'm saying? But like you said, you see that 30, 50, you like, oh, yeah, it's there.
Man.
Like I said, that's crazy because Future, as a rap artist, was saying like every time he went on the road and would do a show, he said, I check my account like 5-7 times. Hey, you know what I'm saying? Because you making sure that you got it bread. You know what I mean? It's like, that's so crazy. I was like, that's what type of time you be on. I said, just imagine.
Speaking of money, while we on that, do you have like a a person that helps you manage your money and all that?
Yeah, so I got an account, got a financial advisory. Nice. I got the whole nine. So I had signed up with that probably like my second year in the league.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I tried to get a little bit more serious about taking care of the money and all that.
Do they make you do that? Or did you do that? Oh, they don't?
The league ain't going to make you do that.
Another tip.
They going to give you what you give you. And it's like, look.
Do what you want.
Hey, bro, tell the people. The people under you that now, bro. Just let them know now.
Like that. That any of the youngins, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like
for real.
If you out here and you grinding and you working to get to the league, make that happen for sure. But when you get there, say that paper, man.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, yeah, you might see the ice and all that look good, cars, whatever. But look, man, save your money.
You know invest.
Take care of yourself while you in the league. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You can have as much fun as you want when you get out, man. You're going to do what you do while you're here. But, man, take care of that paper, man, because that's what's going to save you in the long run. And you got to think about it. You young when you're doing this. By the time you're done, you probably ain't even going to be 30, 34.
Mm-hmm. You still move around. Still got to live.
Right. Like you ain't going to want to be 40, 50, not able to do nothing. Like, you hurt. Yeah. Now you looking for pay.
Mm-hmm. Right. And speaking of, you know, speaking of like businesses, like as far as like you and the accountant hiring that, on the Vibeship TV, bro, we talked a lot about, you know, in our past episodes about entrepreneurship. And, you know what I'm saying? And I feel like, you know, most athletes, when they in the league and they start making money, what's some, do you think about some entrepreneurship avenues that you would like to take on your own personal, I would like to think about investing into certain things, some things that you think that you would like to invest into? As far as, like, it don't got to be anything like stocks, you know, it's like, it could be real estate, it could be business that you want to start up, anything.
I'm going to be 100, you know what I'm saying? So, in my phone, whenever I think of ideas or whatever type plans, anything, I just go to my notes and write it in.
Me and Lays like that. We got big notes.
Anything that might just spark an interest, it's like, all right, let me write this down and I'll come back to it. You feel me?
Right.
So there's a lot of things that I love to do out here that I'm willing to do as soon as I get the opportunity to. Right now, the focus is what the focus is. You know what I'm saying? Just balling, taking care of whatever we could take care of, staying healthy.
So right now, you're a free agent.
Mm-hmm.
You want to go back in the league.
For sure.
So that's like your main priority is like, I want to go back and get it in.
Because you feel like
I ain't accomplished. You want to accomplish some more.
Always.
What would you, I know the goals of everybody, like, I want to get a ring.
Mm-hmm.
But like, you know what I'm saying? How many sacks you had in the league when you was in?
So I think only like three. It wasn't nothing crazy. So, I mean, to be honest, I had more probably TFLs than anything, forced fumbles and stuff like that. The opportunity is all I'm looking for, bro. I didn't got a chance to make it. I didn't play. You know what I'm saying? I didn't see the ins and outs.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I done been on a back burner. I done been ready and not played.
Uh-huh.
So, I mean, you know, I done seen every emotion in this thing.
How many years total?
This is year six.
If you were to quit now, or I'm just saying, like, retire, would you get an NFL pension?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
How many years?
I think 3 credited seasons.
Oh, that's it. 3.
To be qualified for all of that type stuff there. So, yeah, I mean, yeah, we good.
That's what's up.
All that set up. No, I ain't 30 yet, so I know the future plan of 401k and all that.
When you came in the league, anybody tried to do some rookie shit to you?
Say that again.
Anybody tried to do some rookie shit to you? What type of shit was you like? I'm not with that, boy.
This is like my big bro too, like my OG Bruce Irvin. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Bruce Irvin
for sure. You know, he used to always like try to hey Rook man, go get me this, go get me some chips, or hey Rook man, bring some donuts in for the meeting in the morning. Before the game, I'm talking before the flights. You had to go order get grub, like whatever they want. I'd be like, look, hey bro, we want Wingstop, and like, yeah. And then, I want 20 of these, down there get the bill, I'd be like, $350.
Crazy.
And then you might not even touch no wing, so you fire off. You know, we from the street. Yeah. Anyway, so,
I done had that talk.
Like, come on, bro.
Boys, I'm not
like
that.
Like, man, look, I feel like you coming at me, bro. Like, nah, nigga, a little dumb. Just trying to teach you. Look, nigga, I'm a grown ass man.
They be running, going out the wing, stopping shit, behind your wing.
But it's all love, though. It's all love. Like I said, that's the big bro. Like, you know, and the connection that I done built from just doing that.
Helping you, mom.
Being that, being humble and taking the rookie stage. You know, I done been to weddings and got invited to trips and the whole nine. So it's like, it's love. Like, they treat me like a little brother now. Like,
and at that time, they get to communicate with you for real, for real. Yeah. That's really what it be about. Right, I be peeping at you. That's 100, bro.
And you learn, and you getting to learn from a vet. Anybody that's been through five plus years in, it's like, yo, I want to connect with you. How you doing? I'm trying to learn how you did it.
Yeah.
I mean,
be hearing stories and shit about, like, you know, rookies, they be doing foul shit.
Oh, yeah, it gets crazy.
They get wild because, like, I heard some shit Shaq did. It was that disgusted me. I was like, bro. He said, yeah, Shaq used to shit in the bucket for like 2 weeks and pour it on a nigga. I'm like,
what?
Oh, God, you about to die.
I didn't get that physical.
Bro.
Shaq definitely would have been in the news, dog.
You did that to somebody that ain't from the way. When they said that, I was like, bro, he can't be from the way, because there's no way. We didn't get, he's like, yeah, he did that to the little young dude. I said, nah, he didn't get slaughtered on, fam. Boy, it had been on. Like, yeah, I said, I had to pull out the joint in the locker room. Like, nigga, he about to die, bro. He about to get smacked on.
Would have pulled the Gilbert Arenas.
Hell yeah.
Where's my man at? Might have popped him in his leg. Over. Like, what'd he do to you? Like, yeah, ask the nigga. Ask the nigga. Had to get dude up out of here. Yo, bro, tell this nigga.
Why he do that shit, though, bro? What's wrong with him? Did he really do that?
Yeah, nah, bro. It was an interview, bro. They was talking about rookie shit they was doing in NBA, and I was just like,
get me into
it. But I heard shit.
Why would that be okay?
I don't know what made them say that was okay, bro. I wouldn't have been for that. It's like, boys, niggas had that.
Yeah, bro, you gotta.
It's like, somebody violate you in jail, like, bro, he gotta die. You know what I'm saying? You gotta die, bro. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no questions about we. Ain't gonna be no conversations.
This is feces, bro.
Facts. And piss in there, too? Like, oh, that's like, murdering niggas. Yeah. It's on, like, but I just know.
Damn, my little got Shaq different.
Bro, when I heard that story, bro.
Wow.
That shit fucked me up. I was like, what? I said, this nigga did what? I said, yeah. And I just pictured it in my mind, like, we're gonna have to kill nigga. What he did was, dude was sitting in the stall and they dumped it on him.
Ooh. Oh, no, dog. I had to break out of that stall. Yeah, crazy,
something
bro.
Something like that back in the day. Damn. I said, yeah.
Made me drop my phone.
You got to get murdered, bro. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I said. Like, I don't know. Back then, different time, but it ain't going to be with that time. Yeah, like,
it ain't like that. It ain't like that. But you still got to go through your fair share. It ain't rough now.
Yeah, I was like, the one dude was on Gilly the Kids. He's an NFL player. I can't remember his name, but he was saying, like, they was trying to get him to carry the pay. He's like, I'm not with that shit.
He's like,
I'm not carrying that shit.
That's light.
Yeah, he's like, I'm not. Come on, bro. It's hot as hell outside. Niggas are trying to get me to carry the pants. He's like, I'm not doing that. Niggas are looking at him like, what?
Bro, well, let's get it right, bro. Because at the end of the day, when an old head see that you being like that, it's like, now they're going to pick on you way more.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Now they're going to be like, all right, you ain't want to do that. Now I'm about to like,
keep fucking with you.
They're going to come in like, all right, let me get a joke, bro. You know what I'm saying? Let me hear something. What you got? Now it's like, you feel me? You on the spot.
You gonna really be on the spot. That's crazy. That's the worst, too.
I got the life for you now.
Come on.
You done fucked up.
You done fucked up now.
And you feel me? A lot of people, you know, they take that power and abuse it.
Facts.
You gotta worry about, you feel me, who you be around and who got control.
Who know who and who,
you have a control and you don't even know who got control. You be like, all right.
Just like LeBron got control with bringing niggas to the team.
Come on, man. He the GM, man.
Yeah.
Bro, Kobe had
had it. Jordan had it. Like, come on, bro.
Yeah, man, he ain't passing. Yeah. Man, get him off the
phone. Yeah. He said,
or he got all three of them. All three playing as a teammate, like how we play over here.
Even though I'm on the sideline, you can still put me in, coach. You can tell him to go home.
Yeah. Tell that nigga he gotta go.
I can shoot it from here.
Yeah, I say he's not. He said, yeah, just like LeBron told Carmelo to come. Yeah. So he told me to come, and I came. You know what I'm saying? It's like, because that's my man. So I was like, see, if you got that, because what happens is the influence becomes the power. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Once you like Tom Brady got the power, like, you know what I'm saying? Because now you the golden child. You making them the bread, and you making them billions of dollars while you making millions. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Well, that's the fact.
It's only smart that they do that. You know, like you said, like you were saying, bro.
It's your asset.
Absolutely. So why would you want your asset to be surrounded by the best? You want to win. You want to win championships.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And your asset, what do you want? That's what I'm saying. Yeah.
Like Roethlisberger got to pick the plays.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm saying when he stopped this last year, he wasn't able to pick the plays. He is pissed.
Mm-hmm. And I'm even gonna stand. That's like all of us here for bro. Like even us with the podcast, bro. Yeah. You and how you moving, like bro. Everybody, like I said, kids, your nephews, everybody under us sees this,
right?
And they gonna be like, dang, like my big cousin, my uncle, my dad. You know what I'm saying? They're like, dad, they really did some stuff. They're doing stuff. They're still doing stuff. Mm-hmm. They're still pushing. Like, so why am I going? Why am I going to give up? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, bro, they see us not giving up. Mm-hmm. So facts, bro. Like, we definitely, bro, we're definitely doing everything that the youth is going to love within the next 5-10 years.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Even now, bro.
You know what I'm saying? We documenting. You know what I'm saying? Y'all life stories. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? That's why we bringing y'all on this podcast. It's like, y'all, we want you to be Pittsburgh. We ain't never have a light like this.
Yeah.
Sure. We ain't have a light like this. Yeah. It's like to be able to express yourself, be able to tell you, you know what I'm saying, what you got to offer, what you got going on.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like,
somebody driving past, crazy.
Oh yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah,
see me pause like, what's that?
You hit the button?
But you know we gonna edit that. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, it's like bringing it. You know what I'm saying? Full circle is like, you know what I'm saying, is letting the people know. You know what I'm saying? Your background, bro, is like you come from the trenches. You come from where it was hard. You come from. I always try to say there's three spoons. There's the no spoon, and there's a sporket. And then there's the silver spoon. We grew off the sporket.
The sporket.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man. Really I had no spoon.
Really
you know
what I'm saying? Joints in the hood.
Yeah, right. So I know we had the sporket. So it's like, bro, we ain't had the silver, but we had the sporket. We didn't have the no spoon because we ain't in a third world country. You know what I'm saying? We had something. But you know what I'm saying? But we is able to make it with that sporket and turn it into, you know what I mean, gold. And I congratulate you on that, bro, because it's like it take a lot of mental strength. 90% of the time it's not it's not a physical pain, it's a mental pain that you gotta learn how to evaluate your thought process and getting through stuff, like, you know what I'm saying? And like you said, getting your mind right and really focusing on them, you know, the plan. And that's crazy because you're one of, that tells me that the way you think is that I ain't worrying too much about the past and I ain't worrying too much about the future, but I'm worrying about the plan that's set in place and I'm gonna stick to that. Because I know if I stick to that, that's going get me where I need to be.
Everything
in between, I'm going to just deal with it as I go. You know what I'm saying?
You seemingly like the process. You know what I'm saying? Because you know, we're working the process. I'm going to get there. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And
and when you get there, it's going to be glory. So, you know, at the end of the day, just keep working. Put your head down. You know, stay down until the come up.
Yep.
And even when you come up, you know, just enjoy it. And if you fall back down, stay back down until the come back up. It's like a ship, like a vibe ship.
Yeah.
However, it's rocking, man. You just got to be ready to go with the current.
You know? Yeah, facts. You got definitely got to be willing to go with that current.
Yeah.
And, like, speaking of current, how was the flow of the workouts in the gym with the real ass, like, top tier people in the gym?
It's crazy. To be honest, bro, we work out back in the city, like here, like, we work out harder in the city than ever.
Yeah.
Bro, we go out there here, bro. Like, yeah. You know, like anybody that's a pro that's from the city, we all down on the south. We all in the weight room. Yeah. We pushing each other. That's what
we
do.
Right, right.
We grind off each other. You know what I'm saying? It's all love. Mm-hmm. Whenever I see anybody, any of my fellow athletes, even the young dudes that's coming up now, I try to give them game. I want to see them do better than me.
Mm-hmm. Facts, like, right,
you go first round. That's what's up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, Like, I love that.
Right.
I'm going to be the one there rooting for you the whole nine and try to tell you how to stay in it. For as long as you could.
Navigating that world.
You feel me? Because I ain't had nobody to do that for me. I ain't had nobody to show me even how to make it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, everything was off all footwork.
Yeah, it was all your, all the way. And that's so crazy because you say, I ain't had nobody to show me. And that's so crazy because I say that all the time about me even pursuing entrepreneurship, shooting this podcast with them, you know what I'm saying, just going forward. Like, I ain't, bro, nobody didn't show me how to shoot a podcast, bro. Mm-hmm, I had to go look that shit up. Mm-hmm, I had to go find out how it worked.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Nobody didn't show me how to, you know what I'm saying, do these professional things. Like, bro, I had to teach myself. And I always say, like, bro, the most successful people that you know in the world had to teach themselves some type of way. Don't get me wrong. Once they taught themselves, at a certain point in time, that's when the other people come in to help them elevate their dream or help them. Like, like you said, like, there's like some people would be OGs in your life in the NFL. It's like they helped you at certain certain plateaus. Like, all right, now I don't know this shit, but I need to listen to him because he know what I don't know, and it would help you.
Yeah, that's like what we were talking about earlier when I was just saying, like, knowledge is power. Like, you know, if I walk in a room and I know I see somebody in here that's more knowledgeable than me, then I know I'm about to gain some more power out of him because he can help me or something. That's like like asking the right questions, like speaking up whenever you don't know something or you uncertain. It's like if you got people around you in your circle or whatever that's just trying to help you, motivate you, see your purpose, that see your purpose, like keep them around.
Yeah, absolutely. Because they can elevate your whole process a little faster. You know what I'm saying? That's how I look at other people. Like other people that, if this is how I learn faster. It's like if he's where I want to be, where I'm trying to go, I can learn to shorten my learning curve a little quicker because I can learn everything that I'm going to encounter because he went through it already.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like, bro, you already went through it, so I just need to know what I'm going to expect to come. You know what I'm saying? So when I go through it, I ain't going to be all fucked up and not knowing what's going on.
You're up there soaking it up like a sponge, basically, bro. And you can really, like, you can feel it when you talk to people. Like, because it's kind of like that with what I do, bro, like with tees and even what I got on my hat is from, like, what, 96? I can't see it right now. Or 92.
Yeah, 98.6.
All right, 96, you feel me? Like, I had to, when I talk to people, I got to know certain fabric. You feel me? Like, I know for sure if I need to get certain stuff, even like with certain stuff that you wear, bro.
Yeah.
If I get a 2 or 3X, it got to be a certain brand. But I had to learn that. I didn't know that in the beginning, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like you said, it's just soaking
footwork.
It takes all footwork.
Just trying to be somebody that's taking notes.
Facts,
I love to be that. Like, let me just be somebody that's in the background taking all the
notes. Let me hear it.
Who gave you the most knowledge?
Let me hear it.
Like, who gave you, like, the most knowledge, you know what I'm saying, as far as, like, you the most knowledgeable person? Like, when you met them, you like, bro, gave me some real game.
It's crazy, bro, because I've met so many people already that I just love to pick brains, like, especially if I feel comfortable with you or I feel like, you know, I can open up, like, man, look, we could talk, we can get deep, we could conversate about whatever, like, you know what I'm saying, the universe, the seas, whatever, like, because, I mean, at the end of the day, knowledge is knowledge, and everybody got an opinion, so.
They do.
You know what I'm saying? Like, this opening up for the listen.
Right.
The people's opinions and understanding, like, look, bro, like, I understand what your opinion is and I got my opinion. Right. We all gonna have our own
different opinions.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
but we gotta agree on something.
You can agree to disagree too.
Like, we can actually add an ad and still, like, be like, okay, that's understanding. You like white, I like black.
Yeah.
All right, cool.
You know what I'm saying? Just be like, all right, cool. You know what I'm saying?
You can still come back.
People, you know where we come from. It's like, I got a difference. We ain't gonna like each other because we ain't never gonna agree.
But I ain't gonna
like, bro, we ain't gotta be like that.
We don't, but even with where we come from, bro, that's kind of the reason why I be trying to, like, there have been a couple times I've been in a couple situations just to be like, I can diffuse this differently. It could definitely go left, but why won't I just diffuse this differently? Like, I think I had two people, like, they went at it, but it was on some days about the fight, and where they was about to fight at, it's where they really make their money at.
Right.
I'm talking about, like where I go, you know what I'm saying, to make my money.
Yeah, they about to fuck some shit
up. Bro, they're making 10 to 20,000 a month. Which, so you rather fight this young bull for you to fuck your bread up over something that's not even worth it. I had to hit them both with the. I'm like, look, man, they've been on us for in here. We might as well, y'all might as well just squash that shit.
Yeah, that goes into a current event,
just,
bro.
I mean, they just got quiet and left it alone. And I'm like, you feel me? Like,
that's how you time to play. How y'all feel about that, though? Like, that goes into a current event, bro. I just tell my girls, like, I don't agree with Will Smith smacking Chris Rock, bro. You could have checked him from the floor. Mm-hmm. Hey, yo, don't say nothing about my wife, fam. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But though your girl gave you the sad eye, you felt like it was a need because you ain't want to lose your bitch. Yeah. So, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm just being real because you don't want to lose your woman. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, you know she was messing around with other dudes. So a flashback went into that man's head. If your woman's insecure, she don't, like he said on the stage, this is what hit me, bro. This is something my woman said to me. Facts. Says, hey, I need to feel secure and safe that you got me. Mm. You feel me? Women want that if you're going to be in a serious relationship. So when he did that, you feel me? It was acting out on the emotion, just going to like, yo, I don't want my wife to feel secure no more, so I'm going to go slap this man. Yeah. I was like, man, don't give me, basically it's shady, it's funny, it's hell, but it's like, damn, know, bro.
I feel like it had to happen, bro. I'm not saying for who it was, I'm just saying
he definitely,
it's reaction, because you ain't control your emotion, bro. Like, all right, let me be real. If we in a comedy show and then there's a comedy dude on the stage, bro, and he's going ham, and then he starts talking about my wife, you know what I'm saying, right there. I know my wife got a health condition. I know me personally.
He's smacking
personally. I'm going to be like, yo, my wife, bro, nah, she got a health condition, bro. You don't need to talk about that no more. That's what my first words is, just to give you the warning.
Yeah.
And then if you keep going,
no. I'm just saying, bro, we on national television, you feel me? It wasn't like he was like, when he yelled at it, was after the fact, after he slapped
but
him.
He was
like
laughing.
I said, bro, like, bro, he could be laughing in there.
He was laughing, his girl was like,
bro, he's an actor, bro.
She didn't want to know. He was like, saying, oh, shit,
She didn't like the joke. She did that because the joke was corny. You know what I'm saying? That's why she rolled her ass. The joke was corny. You know, and like you said, bro, going back, if she said, bro, all right, you took it as
fucked up your money, though.
You got to smack a nigga from you to feel secure, bro. We got to talk. You know what I'm saying? Because I shouldn't have to smack a nigga.
You agree with each other?
No, I'm not saying that.
Like you said, I'm just saying it as Will.
I don't think it got nothing to do with Jada, bro. Honestly, I don't think it got nothing to do with Jada, bro.
Like, I kind of agree, but I don't agree.
No, I'm just saying this. I don't think it got nothing to do with Jada. That's all I'm saying. I'm just saying, like, I just feel like he just broke.
He broke. He broke.
But now I got something to do with her too. I mean,
yeah, you know,
it's deeply rooted.
Like, you know, something's going
on. He got to the crib. Deeply rooted.
Yeah, it's deeply rooted, man. But at the end of the day, like, a lot of stuff can be prevented if men just talk.
Absolutely.
If men
that's
just
true.
Talk
absolutely.
It out, a lot
that's
of stuff can be prevented.
Hit the button.
You definitely right on that, bro.
Yeah, bro. But we don't know how to talk, dog. We don't know how to talk.
At the end of the day, you know, we let pride and emotions and ego get in the way. And to be honest, you know, like, and it might be opinionated, but real males, if you're moving off emotions, you ain't thinking right.
Absolutely.
Right.
Absolutely.
You know
what I mean? Right.
Like, now you took the logic out.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you took the logic out.
You just disregarded the logic, and now you thinking straight off of how you feel.
Absolutely.
That's why I fuck with this nigga when he said, bro. You took the logic out, nigga. Like, you know what I mean? You just say, oh, no, I fuck the logic.
I'm going to just fuck everything up.
Like, no, bro, you ain't thinking right, bro. You in the right mind space.
That's funny, because I tell people all the time, like my little cousin, bro. I'm like, bro, I'm not a grown ass man. I'm not fighting nobody unless it calls for it. And I'm rarely in a situation where I gotta check
you
somebody.
Put yourself in
I said,
predicament.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I said, don't nobody disrespect me. I said, it's all about how you carry yourself.
As long as nobody ain't putting no hands on you and disrespect your wife or your family,
you good. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
I ain't had to fight in sixth grade, bro. Because like you said, bro, at the end of the day, because already know what a fight is going to do. It's only it ain't healthy for nobody.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm
for both parties.
Like,
it's going to fuck up both. I mean, somebody's going to get fucked up, but the other person's going to be in trouble for this shit. Yeah,
absolutely.
Because in reality, when you was a kid, you could whoop a nigga ass and not go to jail.
Yeah.
But let's be real.
Now you can grow, man. You got consequences.
Somebody like, bro, you going to go to jail for this shit. Like, bro, you can't physically, you just really, yeah, I mean, you just don't know that as you get older. And like I say, like, kids act on emotion. Grown men should be thinking on logic on what needs to be done. And that's a female, that's why they call it a female trait, because women think on emotion. That's not a man supposed to be thinking like that. You supposed to be thinking with your logical sense of bro, this is, nah, if you do that, you already know what's about to happen. Like, mm-hmm. you already know what the situation can occur.
And it would have been, it would be less deaths in the city too, bro. You saying yeah, that shit. You definitely, y'all mm-hmm. right on that shit.
Self-control.
Just
self-control.
Because at the time, by the time Fatty 10 years ago passed, don't even know what the fuck it was about.
Nobody don't even care about that shit.
don't know, yeah. or for what it was about, it was like, why the fuck did you even get that for? Like,
they trigger happy now. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they ain't even fighting no more.
Yeah.
Dang, bro. So
they just pulling, just to pull, bro.
But though,
right on that, bro.
Just another thing on the NFL. We could get back to your conversation because we got into a little bit of that wheel shit. But yeah, you know what I'm saying, but
you started it, nigga.
Yeah, I know I did. I mean, I did. Everybody just went with it.
You know what I mean? I ran right into it. That's
we did. We did.
Bro, said he said
it went down a wormhole out this motherfucker.
I didn't hit it with
Oh, I got everybody.
He wrote us all in.
Yeah,
with
like this. Like, I was like, this nigga ninja slap this nigga.
Gave him a Batman slap.
Oh my God.
Batman robbed him.
You see the whole thing pop up?
Wow. Don't say nothing. Like, keep my wife's name out your said. Fucking mouth.
Oh man. He said, watch your motherfucking mouth.
Yeah. You already got a song out.
Yeah, I know. Like, who made this overnight?
Mouth. Right.
Say, it was a whole Detroit nigga made that jail.
Yeah, bro.
Will Smith got a sugar out of his mouth. But yo, dude seen that. Like, I'm about to make this track right now. Right now. Nigga, I'm about to get on, nigga. Like, nigga, they gonna be playing this shit back.
Drop that shit.
Oh. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, but back to your NFL careers, like, as far as like, what team would you want to be on? You know what I'm saying? If you was, yeah, man, I know you're a free agent, but what team would you want to be on? I know you sometimes
Steelers.
Can't pick, but what?
Steelers.
You would be on the Steelers, beside the Steelers, though, if you didn't.
No, nah, to be honest, bro, now it's about just the team that's offering the best opportunity.
The best opportunity. Mm-hmm. That's usually how it goes.
Yeah, yeah. That's
best opportunity.
That's the main focus. Like, right now, I'm just getting back healthy. You know what I'm saying? Getting my name back out there. Staying
yeah.
in shape.
Yeah, staying big in shape.
Sure, staying in shape.
On top, on yep. top. So you got your agent looking for you right now on what you want, the best opportunity somebody wanted to give you.
Yeah, yeah. You know, my agent gonna handle everything. Whenever mm-hmm. whenever he tap in, I mean, but me and my agent got a good relationship. Like mm-hmm. like that's gonna be one of
keys.
My good friends outside of football. Absolutely. Like,
yeah.
like
and that,
that's how it should.
That's a good. That's good.
Yeah, yeah,
that's real good, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
You want that?
He's a good dude. Yeah. He's a real good dude. You know what I'm saying, New Yorker. You know what I'm saying, so.
That's
all love. Man.
That's
you know
a.
I'm saying he staring
real
me the
friend.
Right way.
Yeah,
like he ain't right. gonna leave me astray, and he know what's mm-hmm. up. Like we talk, like probably twice a month. You know what I'm saying, if not more. You know what I'm saying, and it's
he,
not
he gonna be there after us all said and done life. Too.
Yeah.
yeah, it's life because he seen that's me grow. Up. He seen me grow. He seen me mature into who I am now. Like he used to call me on weekends. Yo, what you doing? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you know now he's like, bro, I know I don't gotta worry about you, bro. Mm-hmm. Like even mm-hmm. if you is home, like he used to in the off season, he used to hate that I came back home
because mm-hmm. like, he was worried.
Like, he's like, yo, yeah. why are you coming back to the city? Like I like you can go to Florida, you can go wherever.
yeah,
like,
no,
bro,
it's a state
like,
of home. Home.
This is
the
home. Yeah. This is where we grind at. Like, yeah, this is it.
Right.
That's what's up, bro. Cause like I said, I keep saying it because it's rare, bro. It's rare. Like even in, whether you're an athlete, whether you're you know, you can rap, you can sing, bro. Most motherfuckers that come back to the city, bro, their city, they get caught up.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know. To, so you like I said, stuff. To be able to have that that mental stability the way you have, I ain't seen it.
Yeah.
I haven't seen yeah. it. You know what I'm saying? It's rare.
It's. I mean, it starts from just knowing how to move. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Who taught me how to move? You know what I mean? Like, yeah. I had a good father figure, man. I had a dad.
You know, right,
he was in the streets, but I had a dad.
He was like, there in so, your you life. Make sure right, that.
Bro, that's the best of both worlds. You
absolutely.
Feel me?
Yeah,
I was
absolutely,
book. I was yep. street smart before I was book smart. Mm-hmm. You feel me? Like, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? So at the end of the day, like, that just made me a better person before I even got the attack yeah. and try to become a man. Because, you know what I'm saying? Like, the people that was in college, uh-huh. they was learning and stuff that I was like, yo, like, I already know this.
Yeah.
Mm, yeah,
second
like,
nature.
And you be yeah. like, bro, you be like, you be like,
you don't know what's going on.
You just jumping out the porch, bro.
Elementary.
You know he got to the flu, right?
Yeah,
he on that porch.
real, they doing shit. You be like, bro, niggas been know about what they get into.
Man, that's just, yeah, old. They be excited about stuff now. You be like, oh my god, man, we ain't even happy about that no more, man.
Yeah, that's crazy that you, yeah, I mean, you experiencing all that, bro. That's what's up, though, bro. You came a long way. Long way, you know what I'm saying? Coming from the hood to the NFL and dealing with it. Even though how I look at Miles, bro, man, me and Ice used to be recording. Miles was going to practice. Bro, you know what I'm saying? My uncle was down there coaching him sometimes, you know what I'm saying? But not on the, like, on the top tier level, like, you know what I mean, his main coach, but just watching him, you know what I mean, playing young, going through the process, and I'm like, bro, he really made it to the league. Like, I mean, really, I see him score. I'm like, oh, he really out here getting it on. It's like, you know what I'm saying? But this is like anybody, but even from our hood, even from Homewood, there's certain people that made it. You'd be like, bro, like, it's possible, not just for athletes, not just for rappers, but even in the entrepreneurship space. That's what I be telling people. It's like, bro, because that's the lane that I'm taking. Like, I could have took the rapper lane. You know what I'm saying? I was never really like a big athlete, but I played football, but it was like, I just know entrepreneurship was my lane for my, that's my sports. Like, that's what I want to be, and that's my game, because that's, I understand, that's the elevation for me. Like, you know what I mean? It's like, if I can get that back to the youth, like I always told them, like, bro, my biggest dream before I go on this planet is to have a company, I mean, have a foundation called the BCBU Foundation. And it's like a Hosetta House, but bigger. And all, it'll be one in Homewood, Wilkesburg, Garfield, all the hoods. And we teach the kids financial literacy. We educate them, we grow them. And we take them to, like, Steve Harvey, and then we would take, like 100 boys to, like, an island. You keep doing that each and every year based off of their work ethic and how good they did well. And you give them that exposure, it changes their dynamic of what they, how they think of themselves and how they see themselves and what's possible. You know what I'm saying? Because in the hood, I didn't think I was going to make it past 18. You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's like my mindset was like, oh, I'm trapping. I know somebody might try to get me because I seen young, everybody down around me, Chandler, but it's mad people just going when we young. And it's like, and they be like, damn, like y'all going, we going, y'all going while we young. I was like, I don't know if I'm going to make it. You know what I'm saying? Somebody might try, you know what I mean, get me. But as I got older and I started living a little longer, and I was like, bro, I done went to business school, did all this stuff. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, I know it's possible. And that's how I know for you personally, you going through your process, you said, like, I knew it. And that's what I feel like drives a person to get where they need to be. It's when they know it in their head before it becomes their reality. You knew it since a kid. So in your mind, when you imprint that into your mind, you say, this is where I want to go, this is what I'm going to do, and this is how I'm going to get there. And no matter what, I'm going to get there. When that determination's locked in like that, bro, you get there. You start seeing your life manifest. So I know when you got there, it was like, I already knew it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I knew it, yeah. You know what I'm saying? I knew I was going to get here. Like, I just ain't know how, but I know it was, it was,
I keep putting this work in.
I try to tell people all the time, like, you feel me? And I don't want to get too spiritual on y'all right now, but, you know, I pray to a higher creator, you know, like this. Like, I believe in the Most High and all that, but, you know, I try to tell people like us, earth folks, you feel me? We God-like, you feel me? The power that we praying to, we like, it's inside of us already. So whatever you already praying for, like, you got it in you. You just got to pull it out. You got to understand how to control it and get it out of you.
I love you said that. I love the fact that you said that, bro, because that's exactly, like you said, I don't try to get too spiritual on nobody, but I always try to tell people, bro, I'm all about meditation. I meditate almost every night before I go to sleep. Because what I understand is your consciousness is meaning, this is something deep, because it's like, it's hard to explain it to people, but I try to help them understand. It's like, bro, your thought, your brain is a computer, bro. It's just thoughts. They're gonna be there all your life. They're, because they're a part of your experiences that you experience through your five senses: taste, smell, hear. Those senses let you know those memories, but you use the memories for wisdom. You don't use them for emotional engagement.
That's real.
You never use the memories for emotional engagement, and that's why a lot of people fucked up, because they're using, they keep living the memory over the pain, the problem. This happened to me. This because they keep living it. But once you say, I let it go, is when you let go the wall. The thought is a wall. You
get to breathe.
You built the wall. But you can't get through it until you say, I don't want to think about it.
Until you don't want
to
deal with it.
Yeah, you don't got to think about it. Like, it's a choice. As long as you indulge into the thought, that's what leads to depression, because now you're digging deeper. Mm-hmm. You're digging a thought deeper and deeper, sure. And then now you're stuck there. Mm-hmm. And if you don't get out of that thought, then you can't ever get out of your depression or whatever you're going through.
Yeah, get out of the thought, or just find somebody that you close to or you can confide in and talk to. Mm-hmm. I try to tell my brothers or people that I love or talk to or communicate to. It's like I call it the G check. Like, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Especially for the males, like you gotta just see how your brother doing. Because we always say we good, we always say we fine. Like, mm-hmm. Oh, I'm all right. But you don't know, really this man probably could have took a 20-pound loss. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? He got this smile on his face, but he's not okay. Probably just lost everything. Yeah. Like, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Check on your homies. Check on your peoples. Like, you know what I'm saying? Make sure they all right. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because, yeah. I mean, and it'd be hard to do sometimes because ain't nobody checking them. Somebody might not be checking on you.
Yeah.
It's like, still, yeah. You know, have that strength, you know what I'm saying? And reach out and try to get somebody some love, man.
It's wild that you say that, though. Yeah, you got to have it, man. I be trying to support as much as I can, bro. Like, my man, it's my homie Godhead. I had his stuff on. I got my man now. It's called Don't Play, you know what I'm saying? Like, I try to, like, support any way that I can. Even if I can't purchase, I'll share. Even if I can't share, I comment, I like. You know what I'm saying? When I bump into you, I let you know, like, what you doing right, what I see, like, your growth. You feel what I'm saying? Like, even come down to you, Dre, Brock, like, and we was talking, I think, last week, and I was like, bro, like, he was saying, like, yeah, we came so far. I'm like, bro, from the beginning to now, like, it's a whole process, and we're already, like, not still grasping it. You know what I mean? But, yeah. like we still grasp it from time to time.
Man, that's just the beginning, bro.
That's like, what I'm saying, like, bro. He was saying that, bro. Yeah, and Brock like, was, too. I was like, damn, I'm like, it ain't right.
Even when,
like,
y'all take off, even when it do blow up, y'all ain't going to reach the full potential of what y'all got still coming.
Right, because it's more in us. Yeah, bro. So much more in us. A whole nother stuff.
It's explosions.
Yeah, like you said, it's all in us. And I definitely believe that. It's like everything that you want is in you. Mm-hmm. Because if you don't, it's like you got to dig inside of you to know who you are and what you're trying to do. And once you start doing that research, then you'll be able to start conquer what you want to do. And this is something that I learned from my mentor that I just learned. I was telling him, I said, bro, he said, give my gift away for free.
Mm-hmm.
He said, that's how businesses win. Mm-hmm. He said, you go in the mall, don't they give you free samples? I said, yeah. He said, if you use a cupcake, you make cupcakes. Mm-hmm. He's like, well, wouldn't you give them out for free? I was like, yeah. He said, that's how you gain business.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I was like, you have to give them value. Yeah. So it's like you said, it's in you. So you give it to them. You like, mm-hmm. I mean, you give them your gift. That's probably what opened up a lot of doors for you.
Because
you gave them, it's like, all right, bro, I'm willing. Mm-hmm. I'm willing to do whatever. Like, bro, yeah, it might be, I don't care if it's for free. This is what I want to do because I know where I'm going with it. Like, you know what I'm saying? Some people be like, oh, I ain't doing this. Like, oh, you don't really want it.
They forget that they the ticket, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's deep.
Like you always like a brand.
Forget that you the ticket,
brand.
Bro.
Facts, yeah. Bro. You a walking brand.
That you kind of you're you know, from what you from start to finish, bro, like how you got in and started in the NFL is kind of similar. I ain't gonna say it's the same, but it kind of hits on kind of feels like Colin Kaepernick a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Because he was you know, from the story that I know, I seen on Netflix, he had to
I didn't get a chance yet.
Okay,
but he had to, you know, he had to do leg work. You know what I'm saying? They wanted him to play baseball. Yeah. He was multi-talented, bro. Yeah. And I was like, bro, this man could have bubbled from anything. Baseball or football, bro. Like,
you watch that movie?
What the?
I mean, the show.
Yeah, for sure.
So when you seen that, do you feel like it's like that?
Oh, for sure.
Mm. Oh, it's really like
for sure.
That.
Mm.
Yeah. I see somebody on a like at a training camp, like all white men.
Oh yeah.
He fell. Niggas, dude walked up and just grabbed the ball and let that nigga sit there.
Yeah.
Like, is it like that? Like, damn. Like, look, that's.
I'm gonna be 100.
That is crazy.
I'm gonna be 100. So I got invited to the combine, the NFL combine.
I was just about to ask you about that.
I didn't get to do it. I couldn't participate in it because I had a shoulder.
Yeah, yeah.
But like being there, I got to experience the whole thing, you know, meet do the meetings, meet all that, do the whole nine. But like throughout the whole process, bro, it's like, yo, what is this, yo? Like, this shit felt like a slave ship or some shit. Like,
you start feeling like
that's powerful.
Feel like you get
powerful.
They got you in tights and you just like
they get
you
running.
DL21. I'm DL21. Like my name ain't my name. I'm DL21.
That's
like,
crazy.
Yeah, you know I mean, so you go up on the stage, they weigh you, they do you, and you just see it's a big stage, like it's in the crowd. It's just
they taking pictures and just talking.
Come on, man,
taking pictures and talking.
It even looks that way on TV, bro. It even looks that way on TV.
He said they looking up there like, yep, all right, I want that one for 100 mil.
You said 6'8", right?
240.
Oh yeah, he's a good one. How many years can we get out of him?
That nigga right there.
That's how they be looking at. How many years can we get out of that?
Yeah, I mean, it's a business. Like it's like we said, it's a business. So you gotta be prepared for that. You
know that.
You gotta know. You know what I'm saying?
That's so funny, bro. It looks that way on TV, bro. Because I was
you want the money? You got to do it.
I was looking at it, bro. They run. It was like, bro, this looks weird. Yeah. But I mean, they know these guys are, you know, they trying to secure their future. They trying to do what they do, but it looks like how you just explained it, bro. It looks like you'd be like, what the hell?
Nah, it's crazy. Man? I mean, like even the day of the running, all that, like you doing the 40, like we be at meetings all morning and whatever. Mm-hmm. So by the time you get on the field, it's like, bro, I'm just trying to do this and
get out of here.
It done drains you out with the meeting and shit.
You done been in Indianapolis for a whole week or whatever. Let me get out of here. Nothing in Indy.
February is
cold. Come on, man.
Y'all in that here, country,
man.
Country.
Yeah. Get out of here,
man. Yeah.
Shit, time too good.
Okay.
That's funny, bro. I used to work for a lady. She used to work at the company. Her name was Doreen Lynch, bro. She was accounting for a small business that I used to work for. Mm-hmm. But she would tell me all the time, but she was like, she wasn't allowed to like talk about
what's going on
in the comment. But she would be like, yeah, you know, I met this, I did this. I'm like, wow.
But look at that word. Look at that word. Colin Ban.
Uh-huh.
Colin Nast.
Yeah.
And then you look at the other word, what they used to call the fields. They used to call it a certain word. So when it's not colonized, Colin Ban, then there's another word that they definitely call it. But it's like, yeah. It's like, yeah, I mean, they know what they're doing, but you know what I'm saying? Because it's just like people, you know what I mean? I was just telling my girl, I said, the world end, they go to Mars. Who you think they taking? All the motherfuckers that's scientists and know shit. Motherfuckers that's lawyers. Nigga, they not taking nobody that got no skills. You ain't got no skills, you ain't going, nigga. If you ain't, you know what I mean, doing something to help to contribute. I mean, you start up a fucking colonization, nigga. You ain't gonna take nobody with no skills that's just chilling on the side, bro. Nah, you gonna need to do that, like, bro. He know how to cut the wood, bro. So we gonna need mans on the john, like, yeah, I mean, he know how to build the houses, bro. Mm-hmm. We gonna need him. So it's common sense. You gonna need what you need. So when you go in that column, man, and they picking out their players, they know how they want to structure the team how they want to build that thing. And you know what I'm saying, what type of, they know all the speeds that everybody is and what they can do with them people on that field.
Yeah.
So yeah, I mean, I get it. You know what I'm saying? You ever met last question, bro. And I'm gonna let y'all ask any other questions that we gonna end it right here. But did you ever meet the coach for the Patriots?
Bill Belichick? Nah.
Never mind. Who was the shadiest coach?
I played against him a couple times. I played against him a couple times, but the shadiest, bro, I'm going to be 100. And I got to put this on wax anyway. John Gruden, bro. Like, man, he's not allowed in the city, bro. Like, yeah, fam, if he come to the city, let me know, man.
He's foul.
I got beef with that, man.
Yeah. Oh, you sort of had to argue with that, man?
He's not 100, bro.
He's not 100.
So,
fake shit.
You know, from what I heard, he got, you know, I think they fired him or something because of that. So is it like that? Is he like that?
Yeah.
He's like
that. Oh, he's like that.
Either the two. But, you know, it's Vibeship TV, man. We had my man TREYVON HESTER stop through, man. We lit this motherfucker up. We had a good conversation with him, bro.
Yes, about his hopes
and dreams, man. And we appreciate y'all for tuning in.
But y'all know it's late like the chips.
It's your boy Dreyking Live.
It's your boy Brock.
It's Vibeship TV.
It's a vibe.
Count. It's a vibe.
Subscribe.